Continental made its first tyre in 1871. It's fair to say the German brand knows a thing or two when it comes to making tyres. And it's no coincidence that they are the most popular brand in the pro peloton. Now, the GP4000 was first introduced 14 years ago, and it's long been regarded as the best all-round road bike tyre available to humanity. I'm a big fan of the GP4000, but now it's being replaced. This is the Continental GP5000. Yep, it's not the 4000 S3 because it's a completely new tyre with a completely new design. Outwardly, well, it's got a sleek new black look and a sexy new box, but let's get them on my bike and learn a bit more about them. I can't believe I'm this excited about a pair of tyres. I think I've got a problem. So this is my first go at mounting the new GP5000. You've got a more precise tread pattern on the new tyre, and this is down to Continental's moulds now being laser cut rather than machined. And it's said to improve cornering grip, but I've got them on my bike now, so let's get them out on the road. Continental reckons that the new 5000 has 12% lower rolling resistance than the 4000. And this is in part down to a new improved black chili compound and a higher 330 TPI, that's threads per inch, carcass. It's also got 20% more puncture protection, which is attributed to an improved Vectran breaker. And it's 5 grams lighter in a 25 millimeter than the previous 4000. It's also said to offer more comfort and reduce road vibration. And this is down to a new way in which Continental actually constructs its tyres and the way the tyre is built. But one of the most exciting things is that there's actually also a tubeless version of this tyre. It's a separate tyre. Now, I haven't got one here, but rest assured, once I manage to get my hands on one, I'll be testing it out and I'll show it to you because it's really exciting. The tubeless version is said to be even faster with 17% better rolling resistance than a GP4000. But how has it developed and what makes it so special? Well, this may surprise you, but Continental isn't claiming that the 5000 is the fastest tyre or the one with the most grip or the one with the most puncture protection or the lightest. But that's the whole point. The design objective with the GP5000, like the 4000, is to produce a tyre with the best all-round performance. You could have the lightest tyre in the world, but it'd be pointless if it meant that you got a puncture before the end of the race. You could have a tyre with the lowest rolling resistance, but that also would be pointless if it meant that you had no grip and slid out on a corner. Much like a track stand, it's all about the balance. Continental has performed extensive research and development into road bike tyres, and a key component of that has been the development of the new compound. But why is the compound so important, you ask? Well, you can't design the optimum compound until you fully understand the demands placed upon the tyre. Now, Continental's research suggested that the actual contact patch on the road is much smaller than previously thought. So take a look at this road, for example. From here, it looks pretty smooth. But when you get down close and take a closer look, you can actually see that it's very bumpy and imperfect. And well, if you were a bacteria, this would be like the Himalayas. Now, the result of this is that, well, Continental thinks that the contact patch is actually just 15% of what you'd actually expect. Of that measly 15%, Continental believes that 98% of a tyre's grip is attributed to the compound. That said, the material properties of that compound become hugely significant. You want it to be grippy, but not too grippy, as that will make it slow. You want it to have low rolling resistance, but if it has too low a rolling resistance, then it won't have enough grip. Some other tyre companies buy in their rubber compounds, but the black chili compound is exclusively developed and constantly improved by Continental. Now, the exact ingredients and procedure that go into making it are top secret. But how do you have good puncture protection in a tyre without compromising the rolling resistance? Well, the answer is Vectran. But what is Vectran, I hear you ask? Well, chemically speaking, it's a polyester formed by the polycondensation of 4-hydroxybenzoic acid with 6-hydroxynaphthalene 2 carboxylic acid. But in non-chemistry nerd terms, it's a fibre that has really high tensile strength, similar to that of Kevlar, and in actual fact, it's used in Mars rovers. It's used in tyres like the 5000 as a very densely woven layer that's still very thin, so it adds a great deal of puncture protection, like a stab vest, but without compromising the rolling resistance. Something else I should tell you is that the tyres are going to be available in 23, 25, 28 and 32 millimetre widths. And the tubeless version, well, that's going to be available in 25, 28 and 32. Now, if you've enjoyed this video, then please give it a thumbs up. And if you'd like to watch another tyre related video, then click down here on the tyres for one on how to set your tyre pressures.